Welcome to a special edition of The Inside Voice. Composers and clinicians John Jacobson, Cristi Miller, Rollo Dilworth, and Roger Emerson discuss the joys and challenges of music education, focusing on teacher-student relationships, repertoire, the value of reading sessions, and more.
Talk again about how important it is for us to continue having reading sessions, live events such as this, for teachers.
We are connected as people, and I think it's never better demonstrated than in a choir. A choir, a band, an orchestra is something you cannot do by yourself. You need other people to be involved in it. And we need to be more connected as a society. And as we as music teachers, I think, reflect that in our choirs, then maybe it will spread, and we know it will spread, through the arts to the rest of humanity. That's a pretty profound undertaking, but I think it's one we all take pretty seriously.
Kids are here on their phones and things, and we're becoming, as adults, when we always use a website to find music, I would say just as guilty of that disconnect. And we're trying to make a connection. We're trying to build community within our ensembles. So I think the importance of reading sessions is we are continuing to build that community and that joy of singing and the way it feels. You know, I don't want to lose that for sure.
One of the notable reasons that I think it's so important and found it so helpful when I was teaching was that you realize that you're not, oftentimes you're the only music teacher or one of two music teachers in
the
building.
Right.
And the networking aspect of something like this, to realize that there's others, the energy, you can't find that online looking at music, even though it's a great thing to be able to listen to recordings and look at PDFs online. It doesn't really replace a live event.
I mean, we had so much fun just as presenters because of the fun that we saw them having. Right. You can't do that at home. You can learn the music, you can hear the recordings, but I have so many people that came up to me today and said, you know that statement that you said about this, that? I can't thank you enough for that. I'm thinking, I didn't even intend for that to be a teaching moment. It was just something that I said. But that's what happens with them at lunch. That's what happens all through the day, that they get to experience that. You can't get that anyplace else but here.
I agree. I mean, in addition to music making being a communal experience, which I think we've all touched upon, there's an opportunity for these teachers to come together and to build their musicianship skills. Mm-hmm. And that's something that you never stop working on. You get to build your teaching skills. And while it may be convenient, if you will, for sometimes, you know, to sit alone and to listen to something online, the opportunity to become a better musician, to learn skills that's going to help you to be a better teacher, is ultimately going to help the teacher to be better in the classroom with their students. And I think that that is definitely a takeaway that you have to treasure in an experience like this.
And you're getting together with your friends and singing.
I know.
Yeah.
What could be
better than that? Well, that's very true.
Or dancing.
Okay. Even better.
Absolutely.
Well, we don't want to see these go away, so we want to see these better attended in the future. So.